Welcome dear students, today we are going to discuss how to determine percent NaCl in a solution using phenol water system by critical solution temperature method. Aim of practical: to determine percent composition of NaCl in a solution using phenol water system by CST method. Requirements: chemicals, phenol, distilled water, sodium chloride. The apparatus required to conduct the experiment: hard glass boiling tube, beakers, pipette, electronic weighing balance, thermometer. And water bath. Before moving towards the experimental part, we'll go through some theory related with this phenol water system. Now, first of all, we'll see Gibbs phase rule. So, Joseph Willard Gibbs formulated a phase rule which is helpful to say the relationship between the least number of variables required to define the state of system. This critical number called as F and rule given as F is equal to C minus P plus 2, where this C is number of components and P is a number of phases present into the system. Now we'll see one by one what is phase. So as homogeneous physically distinct portion of system that is separated from other portion of the system by bounding surfaces is known as phase. A liquid water and water vapor consist of two phases, and liquid water and water vapor and solid ice is consist of three phases, that is liquid, vapor and solid. And this first example, liquid and vapor, these are the two phases. The number of components present in the system, it is the smallest number of constituents by which the composition of each phase in the system at equilibrium can be expressed in the form of chemical formula or equation. So take an example of water that exists as in a liquid, solid and vapor phase, but the composition of system remain constant. Means chemical entities present into the systems is nothing but your number of components. In phenol water system, two constituents are there. First one is phenol and second one is water. So it is two phase system. The number of degrees of freedom, how can we calculate it? By using Gibbs phase rule. So least number of intensity variable that must be fixed or known to describe the system completely. A system with F is equal to 0 is known as non-variant and or having a no degree of freedom. A system with F is equal to 1 means univariant, means only one component is required to explain our system completely. Then if F is equal to 2, then system is known as bivariant. So for explaining your system completely, you require at least two parameters. Now which parameters we should consider, that is temperature, pressure, concentration. Then we'll see solubility of liquid in liquid. The composition of each component in the two conjugate phases, an amount of one phase relative to other can be calculated. In case of some liquid pairs, solubility increases as temperature decreases and system will exhibit lower consolute temperature. Means when you decrease the temperature, the two immiscible phases become homogeneous. Example, triethylamine and water. Some liquid pairs shows upper critical temperature and lower critical temperature. Example, nicotinic and water. Then phenol water system, it shows upper consolute temperature. So when you plot a graph temperature versus phenol in water, this is the maximum temperature at which your system will show homogeneous form of the solution. Then above this temperature, this phenol water system is having a homogeneous form. In cases of partial miscibility, degree of miscibility may be dependent on a temperature. Solubility increases with increase in temperature. Example, phenol water system. Then solubility decreases with increase in temperature. Example, water, triethylamine. Then solubility increases with decrease or increase in temperature, that is nicotine and water system. So this system will give us upper as well as lower consolute temperature. Then solubility not affected by temperature. So these are the different cases of partial miscibility. In a case of three component system, third liquid may influence a degree of solubility of second liquid system. Then effect of temperature variation on degree of miscibility in the system is described by means of phase diagram. So this is the phase diagram. Initially we have taken amount of phenol, then slowly you increase amount of water in this phase, and you have to determine what transition temperature is required to make your system homogeneous. So likewise you have to proceed with addition of water, and you have to determine critical solution temperature. Then you will get a different reading, and by using the different readings you can plot this graph. This graph is dome shape. So this upper part will give you upper consolute temperature. So all proportion of your phenol and water above this graph will shows homogeneous solution, and below to this curve or dome will give us heterogeneous system. There is a separation of phenol and water. Now we'll see two component system. The curve GBHCI shows limit of temperature and concentration within which two liquid phases exist in equilibrium. The region outside this curve contain one liquid phase. So if you consider this graph, so this is curve. GBHCI. Then a region outside this curve, means if you take a region outside of this curve, will give you pure phenol water system as a one liquid phase. So starting at a point equivalent to the system containing 100% water at a 50 degree centigrade and adding a known increment of phenol to fixed weight of water, whole being maintained at a 50 degree centigrade, will result in formation of single liquid until point B is reached. Then at point B, a minute amount of second phase appears, and the concentration of phenol water at which this occurs is 11% weight by phenol in water. Analysis of the second phase, which separates out on the bottom, shows it to contain 63% by weight of phenol in water. This phenol rich phase is denoted by point C on the phase diagram. So as we prepare a mixture containing increasing quantities of phenol, that is, as we proceed across a diagram from point B to C, we form a system in which the amount of phenol rich phase continuously increases, as denoted by S2. At the same time, the amount of water rich phase decreases, and once a total concentration of phenol exceed 63% at 50 degree centigrade, single phenol rich liquid phase is formed. So the line BC drawn across a region containing two phases is termed as tie line. All system prepared on a tie line at equilibrium will separate into two phases of constant composition. These phases are termed as conjugate phases. Any system represented by a point on the line BC at 50 degree centigrade separate to give a pair of conjugate phases whose composition are B and C. Then the critical solution temperature, that is upper constant temperature, is a maximum temperature at which two phase region exists. In the case of phenol water system, this CST is 66.8 degrees centigrade. All combinations of phenol and water above this temperature are completely miscible and in one phase liquid system. So all combination of phenol and water at 66.8 degree centigrade and more than this temperature will give us homogeneous form. Now we'll see procedure part. The process of determination of this unknown concentration of NaCl by using phenol water system is divided into the two parts. So in first part, we'll see how to determine critical solution temperature of phenol water system, and in second part we'll discuss how to determine unknown concentration of NaCl in the solution. So first part, clean and dry all glass vessels, predict accurately a 4 gram of phenol. Then weigh accurately 4 gram of phenol or 3.7 ml of phenol and transfer to hard glass boiling test tube. Then add 2 ml distilled water to that phenol in test tube and heat test tube in water bath whose temperature is set to 40 degree centigrade. on a low flame with constant stirring. Then note temperature T1 of solution at which a clear solution is obtained. Then take out this tube from water bath and allow it to cool. When it shows a turbid appearance, note the temperature T2. So when you will get clear solution, then you have to determine temperature, and this will be your T1 temperature. And when you remove this hard glass tube, which consists of phenol and water, from water bath, it starts to convert into the turbid form. So at that time again you have to measure a temperature, and this will be your T2 temperature. Then you have to take a mean of this T1 and T2 temperature. This will be your transition temperature T. Again, in the same tube, you have to add 2 ml of distilled water and determine transition temperature T1, T2, and then take an average of this T1 and T2. So repeat transition temperature determination by adding 2 ml of water each time. So you have to continue with addition of 2 ml of water in the same tube, and then determine T1, T2. Then carry on the determination till transition temperature reaches maximum and fall back to the 40 degrees centigrade. So if you observe this temperature, initially it is increases, okay, after reaching a certain level it starts to fall back. So when it fall back up to 40 degrees centigrade, then you have to stop your experiment. Then plot a graph of percent composition versus transition temperature and determine critical solution temperature at the highest point on the dome. So this is your procedure for the determination of critical solution temperature of phenol water. Then in second part, you have to prepare 1%, 2%, 3%, 4%, 5%, and one unknown percent of sodium chloride solution in distilled water. In another test tube, you have to take another hard glass tube, you have to take 4 grams of phenol, and in that test tube add NaCl solution and determine CST. Similarly, determine CST for each solution for 2%, 3%, 4% and 5% of your NaCl solution. Along with this, you have to determine critical solution temperature of this unknown percentage of NaCl solution. Then you have to plot a graph of CST of all known solution and NaCl in a system on a y-axis and the composition on x-axis. Then join all points to obtain a line. Then you have your unknown CST of unknown solution with you. Then that CST you have to extrapolate on a graph, and you can determine its composition. Then precautions you require to take during conduction of experiment. As we all know, phenol is colorless and very corrosive acid, so you have to handle it with due care. Do not touch it while recording temperature. See that it is away from the your body and hold it into the sink. If there is a breaking of test tube, then phenol should not fall on your body or on a platform, so it will fall into the sink. Never keep it out, but phenol rather use measuring cylinder. So instead of pipette, you have to use a measuring cylinder. Accurately note the temperature when system become clear or turbid. While heating, the system temperature increment should not be more than 1 degree centigrade. So these type of the precautions you require to take during actual conduction of experiment. So now we'll see actual demonstration of practical. How to determine unknown concentration of NaCl by using phenol water system. So for that purpose, first of all, we are going to determine critical solution temperature of phenol water system. Phenol and water both are immiscible liquid. So we are going to determine at what temperature it will give you homogeneous mixture. And that temperature is known as critical solution temperature. For conduction of this experiment, we will require phenol, then distilled water, then hard glass tube, measuring cylinder and test tube holder. So I am going to take this phenol 3.73 ml into this hard glass tube. Phenol is corrosive in nature, that's why during performing experiment we have to wear hand gloves and do not touch your body with this phenol because it is corrosive. Then I am going to add distilled water in this phenol. Now here in this measuring cylinder, I have taken 2 ml of distilled water. We have to add this distilled water into this hard glass tube. Then it looks like hazy. Now we are going to heat it. Okay, this is a hazy form of your phenol water because both are immiscible at room temperature. So I am going to keep it into the water bath. So as a temperature increases, it is converted into the homogeneous system. This preheated water bath, which is having a temperature 40 degree centigrade, now if you observe it, it is converted into the clear liquid. When I hold this tube into the water bath, its temperature increases, and because of this increased temperature, this heterogeneous system is converted into the homogeneous system because we have achieved a critical temperature of phenol water system. Now we'll measure temperature of this system with the help of thermometer. It is a 45 degree centigrade. Now again I am going to add a 2 ml of distilled water in these same tube. Again it is converted into a turbid form. Okay, after cooling, again you have to take a measure a temperature. Again, we have to add
2 ml water, and again you have to fold it into the water bath. Again it starts to convert into the clear liquid. Temperature which is measured when your liquid is clear, this will be your T1 temperature, and after cooling you have to measure a temperature, this will be your T2 value. Now it is converted into the clear form. Now immediately you have to measure the temperature of cysteine, the T 48°C. Now you have to cool it. Then again it will start to convert into the hazy form. Now this liquid is looks like a hazy because we cooled it. So its temperature is 42°C. Again I am going to add 2 ml of water in the same test tube. Again it is hazy, so we require to convert it into the clear form. So again I am going to hold it into the water bath. It starts to convert into the clear form. Now it is converted into the homogeneous mixture, and the temperature of this phenol water system is 56°C. So again I am going to cool it and I will measure a temperature of the system. Water is going to be hazy form. So the temperature of system is 54°C. Again I am going to add. Again I have added 2 ml distilled water in the same tube, and I am going to heat it. As a temperature of your system increases, slowly slowly it is converted into the homogeneous system, and when you remove this tube from water bath, immediately it is converted into the turbid form. Now it is converted into the clear form, and temperature of this phenol water mixture is 68°C. So again I will cool it and I will measure when it converted into the hazy form or turbid form. Okay, it is hazy now, and temperature is 64°C. Again I add 2 ml distilled water and I heat it. again you have to heat it, then it is converted into the clear form and our temperature of system is 58 degrees centigrade. Now again I'll cool it. After cooling, again it shows the temperature 54 degree centigrade. If you observe it, your T1 and T2 values of a previous reading was higher and it starts to decrease from this reading. Okay, now we'll see what happened in next part. Again, I'm going to add 2 ml of water in the same system. And I'm going to heat it. After heating this system, it is converted into the clear form and it shows a temperature 52 degrees centigrade. Again, I'll cool it. And after cooling, it shows a temperature 48 degrees centigrade. Now what you have to do, likewise you have to take readings after addition of water, still you will get a value of T1 and T2. Average value of T1 and T2, it should be close to 45. Up till now you have to take these readings.
Now we'll see observations and observation table. First observation, that is density of distilled water, it is calculated and it is 1.04 gram per ml. Then density of phenol, it is 1.071 gram per ml. Then third observation, weight of phenol. So this weight of phenol is 4 gram. Then observation table, volume of water added in ml. So we are sequentially added 2 ml of water in the same tube. That's why volume of your water initially 2 ml. After addition of 2 more ml, it will become 4. After addition of 2 more ml, it will become 6. So likewise, amount of water goes on increasing. Then second, weight of water. So how can you calculate weight of water? Density into volume. So here density of water is 1.04. Just we have to multiply this volume with 1.04. Then you will get value of W2. 2 into 1.04, 4 into 1.04. Then likewise I have calculated here value of W2. Then next column, that is phenol percent weight by weight calculation. In these calculation, what you have to do, W1 divided by W1 plus W2 into 100. Here W1 is weight of your phenol, that is 4 gram. Then again you have to divide this W1 with W1 plus W2. So here W2 value is this value, 2.04, 4.16 for the respective volume of water. Then by using this formula, I have calculated here phenol percent weight by weight value. Okay, for this first reading, we'll see how it is calculated. W1, that is 4 gram divided by 4 plus 2.04 gram into 100. So after calculating this, final answer is 66% weight by weight of phenol is there. Then for this system, I have calculated transition temperature, that is T1 and T2. And that obtained temperature T1 is 45 and T2 is 42. Okay, T1 is a temperature when your solution is clear. When you put your solution into the water bath and it is clear, so it is 45. And after cooling it, when it converted it to the turbid form, then it is 42. then average of this 45 and 42 is 44 degree centigrade. Okay, likewise you have calculate this transition temperature of phenol water system. Then we required to plot a graph. So temperature versus percent composition of phenol. Then here I have plotted this graph, and by using this graph we'll come to know that what exactly the critical solution temperature of the system, and as per this reading the obtained critical solution temperature is 66 degree centigrade. So it is a maximum temperature that is 66 degree centigrade. The points which are lies below to this dome shaped graph, they are showing that your phenol and water is biphasic in nature, and above this temperature all combinations of phenol and water shows homogeneous mixture. So this is your critical solution temperature, that is 66 degree centigrade. Then we'll see second part of this experiment. In the second part we have prepared the different concentrations of NaCl, that is 1%, 2%, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, then we have taken this 3.73 ml of phenol and added this 2 ml of 1% NaCl solution, and then taken the transition temperature, that is T1, T2, and average of this T1 and T2 is your T value. Then likewise you have to calculate for 2%, 3%, 4% and 5%. Then these are the obtained values of transition temperature for different concentrations of NaCl. Then last reading, that is your unknown concentration. Here I have taken unknown concentration of NaCl and this 2 ml unknown concentration mixed with phenol, and a reading for the transition temperatures are taken. Then you required to plot a graph, and here I have plotted a graph critical solution temperature versus percent NaCl. Okay, now we don't know percent NaCl. We have a reading of this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5% of NaCl. Just you have to show these points on a graph and make a straight line, and the reading which is obtained from your unknown solution of or unknown concentration of NaCl, that critical solution temperature you require to extrapolate on this graph. And when I extrapolate this reading on the straight line, I receive the reading, that is 2.5%. So unknown concentration of your percent NaCl is 2.5%. Result: the CST of phenol water system was found to be 66 degree centigrade. Then result for the second part: the unknown concentration or percent composition of NaCl in a solution using phenol water system by CST method was found to be 2.5% wet by volume. Now we'll move toward the synopsis and viva questions. These type of the questions are asked for the synopsis. First, who formed a phase rule? So answer is, J. Willard Gibbs formulated a phase rule, which is helpful to state relationship between least number of variables required to define the state of the system. Then second question, what is phase rule? So phase rule is F is equal to C minus P plus 2, where F is degrees of freedom, C is number of components involved into the particular system, and P is a number of phases present into the system. Then थर्ड क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज फेज कंपोनेंट एंड डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम? फेज एज अ होमोजेनियस फिजिकली डिस्टिंक्ट पोर्शन ऑफ सिस्टम दैट इज सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम अदर पोर्शन ऑफ द सिस्टम बाय बाउंडिंग द सरफेस. देन कंपोनेंट, इट इज अ स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स by which the composition of each phase in the system at equilibrium can be expressed in the form of chemical formula or equation. Then degree of freedom, it is a least number of intensive variable that must be fixed or known to describe the system completely. How much is a critical solution temperature for phenol water system? Answer is 66 degree centigrade. Then what is UCT, that is upper absolute temperature? It is also known as the UCST, that is upper absolute solution temperature, or upper absolute temperature is the critical temperature above which the component of mixtures are miscible in all proportions. Then what is LCT, that is lower absolute temperature? The lower critical solution temperature or lower absolute temperature is the critical temperature below which the component of mixture are miscible for all composition. What is effect of addition of NaCl on CST of phenol water system? So what happened due to addition of NaCl and KCl, there was increase into the critical solution temperature of phenol water system. This is all about questions that will be asked for the synopsis and viva. Thank you.